To assist us with solving the Rubik's Cube, we need to define some standard notation to make our lives a bit easier. Using this notation, we can then denote sequences of moves, which are called algorithms, which help us solve the puzzle. So in this video, I'm going to teach you the notation for turning the sides of the Rubik's Cube, as well as a simple example of an algorithm using that notation. Okay, so if we hold the cube in a fixed orientation, with one side on the top and one side on the front, there are six possible sides that we can turn. The front side, the back side, the top side, the bottom side, the left side, and the right side. And to help make our lives easier, we denote the sides with the following letters. So F is for front, B is for back, L is for left, R is for right, U is for up or top, and D is for down or bottom. And notice when I was doing those moves, I kept all the centers fixed and simply turned the layer around the centers. And that's what the notation specifies. From here, the notation for turning a cube is pretty simple. So a single letter by itself means that we turn the face 90 degrees clockwise. So for example, U is simply turn the top face 90 degrees clockwise. If we get a U prime, that means turn the top layer 90 degrees anti-clockwise. If we get a U2, that means we have to turn the top layer 180 degrees, so U twice. To familiarize yourself with this notation, try thinking of a notated move and then perform the corresponding turn on a cube. It can sometimes be slightly confusing deciding which way is clockwise and which way is anti-clockwise, and it takes a little bit of practice to get used to this. So the easiest way to tell which is clockwise and which is anti-clockwise for a particular side is to look at the side front on and then make the turn. So for example, an F is like so because we're turning it clockwise. Whereas L, which is to turn the left side 90 degrees clockwise, comes down like that. So if we look at the left side, we're rotating it clockwise. And so the L turn comes towards you, but if we do an R, which is the right side 90 degrees clockwise, that actually goes, I guess, away from you. Because when you look at the right side front on, you're turning it clockwise away from you like that. A crucial component to solving the Rubik's Cube is the use of what are called algorithms. Now, upon first impression, this term may seem frightening, but algorithms are quite simple. So they're sequences of moves which transform the cube from one state to another, which are, I guess, aimed at achieving a particular result or outcome. So we can use the notation that we developed to describe algorithms or sequences of moves. So a simple algorithm could be something along the lines of R, U, R prime, F2. And that's just four random moves, but you can see how with this notation we can clearly describe which faces to turn. So we'll be using this notation and algorithms to help us solve the cube with the beginner's method, so it's important to familiarize yourself with the notation.